Now let us discuss about control or regulation of spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis is mainly regulated by hypothalamo-hypophyseal testicular axis. GnRH hormone is released from hypothalamus, which acts on anterior pituitary to release two hormones, that is luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. Luteinizing hormone acts on Leydig cells and follicle stimulating hormone acts on Sertoli cells. The luteinizing hormone, which acts on Leydig cell, causes production of androgens, which exert a negative feedback inhibition on on the secretion of luteinizing hormone and gonadotropin releasing hormone. The androgens released from Leydig cell mainly act on Sertoli cell and promote spermatogenesis. The follicle stimulating hormone is another hormone which is secreted from anterior pituitary. This hormone acts on Sertoli cells and promotes spermatogenesis. On stimulation of Sertoli cells, under the influence of follicle stimulating hormone, it also causes production of inhibin B. Now this inhibin B exerts a negative feedback inhibition on secretion of follicle stimulating hormone. That is how hypothalamo-hypophyseal testicular axis acts in regulating spermatogenesis. Other hormones important for spermatogenesis are growth hormone and testosterone. Now let us see what are the factors affecting spermatogenesis. This is separate from the regulation of spermatogenesis. Factors affecting spermatogenesis are mainly the temperature and seasonal variation. Generally, a temperature of about 2% less than core body temperature is required for normal production of spermatogenesis, which is maintained by two mechanisms. Number one, countercurrent mechanism operating between testicular artery and pampiniform plexus, and also the location of testes in scrotal sacs outside the abdomen, which maintains the body the temperature around the testes are about 2 degree centigrade less than core body temperature. So that's all about the regulation of spermatogenesis and factors affecting spermatogenesis.